Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Joanne, and I am delighted to be here to conduct your marriage ceremony. My colleague Jane is here to ensure the legality of your marriage, to record the details in the marriage register, and to issue your marriage certificate. We have gathered here on this happy occasion to witness the marriage of Michael and Kerry, who now wish to make their vows for a lifelong union in the presence of their families and friends. We are delighted to be here with you to share in this special celebration and hope that today will be a happy and memorable one for you all. Michael and Kerry are about to declare their love for each other. Marriage is a lifelong commitment, and this important day marks the starting point of their new life together. The place in which we are now met has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriages. I am now required to ask that if any person here present knows of any just cause or impediment, that is any legal reason, why Michael Bernard Walsh and Kerry Louise Harris should not be married, they should declare it now. One of the many historic customs involved in the wedding ceremony is the giving away of the bride. Today, this act is seen as a symbol of support for her marriage and a promise of continued trust and affection from her family. Who presents Kerry to be married to Michael?
I do.
Would you like to
give
her a kiss on the cheek? I can. Would you want to take your seat with me? Before you are joined in matrimony, I have to remind you both of the solemn and binding character of the vows you are about to make. Marriage in this country means the union of two people voluntarily entered into for life to the exclusion of all others. It is a solemn union to provide the love and friendship, help and comfort each ought to have for the other. It should not be entered into lightly, nor should it be lightly set aside. Now there are two declarations that you are about to make. In the first, you will be stating that there is no reason in law why you should not be married to each other. And in the second, you will agree to take each other as husband and wife according to the law of this country. So, Michael, you go first. If you could please repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why
I, Michael Bernard Walsh, may not be joined in matrimony
to Kerry Louise Harris.
To Kerry Louise Harris.
Thank you. Okay. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare
that I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Kerry Louise Harris.
May not be joined in matrimony. May not be joined in matrimony.
To Michael Bernard Walsh.
To Michael Bernard Walsh.
Thank you. Michael and Kerry, you have invited here today your families and friends to receive their encouragement and support at this very special time. So with their support, will you please make your promises to each other? So would you like to just pop your book out on the desk for me? And would you like to turn and face each other? And would you like to hold hands?
Yes, please. Stop falling over.
The next part is in the form of a question. So, Michael, if you could repeat after me and say to your bride, today, Kerry, as you become my wife.
Today, Kerry, as you become my wife.
Will you promise to be loving?
Will you promise to be loving?
Loyal and faithful.
Loyal and faithful.
For the rest of our lives.
For the rest of our lives.
I will.
And then you repeat the same to Michael. And Michael, today, as you become my husband.
Michael, today, as you become my husband.
Will you promise to be honest?
Will you promise to be honest?
Devoted and faithful.
Devoted and faithful.
For the rest of our lives.
For the rest of our lives.
I will.
Now, the solemn and important moment has come where Michael and Kerry take each other as husband and wife in the presence of their witnesses here assembled. As a sign of support for their marriage, would everyone in the room who is able please stand? And then Michael, if you could repeat after me and say to your bride, I call upon these persons.
I call upon these persons.
Here present to witness.
Here present to witness.
That I, Michael Bernard Walsh.
That I, Michael Bernard Walsh.
Do take thee, Kerry Louise Harris.
Do take thee, Kerry Louise Harris.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
Thank you. And Kerry. I call upon these persons.
I call upon these persons.
Here present to witness.
Here present to witness.
That I, Kerry Louise Harris.
That I, Kerry Louise Harris.
Do take thee, Michael Bernard Walsh.
Do take thee, Michael Bernard Walsh.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
Thank you. If all the guests would like to be seated. There is a tradition in this country for the marriage contract to be sealed by the giving and receiving of rings. A ring is an unbroken circle that symbolises unending and everlasting love. It is the outward sign of the lifelong promises you are making today to each other. So would you like to step forward with the rings, and would you like to give the groom the bride's ring first? Okay, would you like to pop that ring on the edge of your bride's finger and then say to her, Kerry, I give you this ring.
Kerry, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love and affection. As a symbol of my love and affection.
As a symbol of my love and affection.
Please wear it with happiness and pride.
Please wear it with happiness and pride.
Now and always.
Now and always.
Thank you. Do you want to push that ring on? Okay, would you like to give the bride the groom's ring, please?
Thank you.
Do you want to pop that ring on your groom's finger and then say to him, Michael, I give you this ring.
Michael, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love and affection.
As a symbol of my love and affection.
Please wear it with happiness and pride.
Please wear it with happiness and pride.
Now and always.
Now and always.
Thank you. Do you want to push that ring on? Okay. Would you two like to just take a seat for a second? Right, we're now going to have a reading. It's going to be read by Jo, and it's called On Your Wedding Day. Do you want to stand at the front here?
On your wedding day. Today is a day you will always remember, the greatest in anyone's life. You'll start off the day just two people in love and end it as husband and wife. It's a brand new beginning, the start of a journey, and end with moments to cherish and treasure. And although there'll be times when you both disagree, they will surely be outweighed by pleasure. You'll have heard many words of advice in the past when the secrets of marriage were spoken. Well, you know that the answers lie hidden inside, where the bond of true love lies unbroken. So live happy forever as lovers and friends. It's the dawn of a new life for you, as you stand there together with love in your eyes from the moment you say, "I do." And with luck, all your hopes and your dreams can be real. May success find its way to your heart. Tomorrow can bring you the greatest of joys, but today is the day it all starts.
Marriage is a commitment for life in which people can find and bring out the best in each other. It offers opportunities for sharing and growth that no other relationship can equal. When two people pledge to love and care for each other in marriage, they create a spirit unique to themselves, which binds them closer than any spoken or written word. Marriage is a promise which you have both taken and has been made in the hearts of two people who love one another. We all share in your happiness and give you our best wishes for your future life together. It is now my privilege to announce that you are now husband and wife.